Welcome to September. Here's your psychic tarot reading for the month. This month, this is what we will go over. We will cover your current self, the month's theme, you at the beginning, middle, and end of the month, the key goal to achieve, how to do it, obstacles to overcome, how to do it, good news, what to avoid, your spirituality modality of focus this month to help you get through it. And then I wanted to let you know that when I polled people on Instagram and on Facebook, they all said what they really wanted to focus on this month was money and career. So I will be putting that in a separate set of videos for you this month to this YouTube channel, and hit the little bell notification so that when those come out, you are immediately aware and alerted in case you like these. I would also appreciate it if you would share these videos with people that you think would find helpful, because otherwise, how are they going to find them, right? And here's something new that we're doing this month. If you are to go ahead and share this video on Facebook or Instagram, please go ahead and tag me, because this month I'm giving away a zodiac sign necklace, which obviously it would be the one. If you're a Pisces, that'd be the one that you want to share, right? In this picture, this is an example of the different Pisces necklaces that would be going out, but I have them for every single sign. Those would be shipped out halfway through the month, so make sure that you tag me in it. Because if you don't, I can't see the post, and then I can't DM you for your shipping address. So I'll be giving away one for each one of these signs. Let's get started. Hi, Libra. Welcome to September. Happy birthday at the end of this month. Let's just get to it. So your current self this month, all about work, new beginnings in work and money. This is an opportunity time. This is a good time to buy a new house. I would definitely say September, just because the retrograde starts at end of October, would be a way better time to get those plans in motion, to get things moving. So absolutely take advantage of those things. And they say the month's theme is joy, and this is going to touch all of your chakras. So excuse my sniffly nose. I'm so sorry. There we go. I think I got it. How gross is that? I just swallowed boogers. Anyway. But I did it for you because I love you. So crown chakra, experiencing joy in those spiritual moments. Your third eye, opening your eyes to see things you didn't notice before and experiencing the joy and the beauty in those moments. Speaking joy, feeling it, appreciating your own self, your own body, understanding that our fears are there to protect us, and then also what we already have in the physical plane. Because appreciating and feeling joy for the things that we already have, expressing gratitude for those, are just going to further potentiate those opportunities that I mentioned. So it says you delight in the love of life and bring a spirit of fun to all that you do. And so absolutely, this is a good time to take advantage of new opportunities on the earthly plane, things that would bring us more money or create like a better, more stable environment for us. This could be work stuff, things like that. And just so you know, I think I did mention money and career will be coming in a separate set of videos, but you'll definitely want to check that out just because that's where we're at right now in the beginning of September. So beginning of September, they're saying like you're not really attached to anything toxic, any old cycles that were holding you back previously. Those have now been released. So that's fantastic. In the middle of September, they're saying you might not be feeling super powerful and successful, like you're giving a lot of yourself and not necessarily seeing the results right away. But what they're saying is this might make you feel like, if you're watching this in the middle of September, you'd be like, oh, that first theme that we started with, that current self, you know, new opportunities and things coming through for me, I don't really see it. I don't really believe that. That's not resonating for me. And they're saying, but if you are challenging yourself to remember that it might be worth it, you know, that things might be brewing behind the scenes for you, that is absolutely the case. So don't lose sight of that joy, okay? And then at the end of September, they're saying things are going to work out like outside of your control. So it's like you put a lot of effort in, you take advantage of opportunities in the beginning, you work really hard in the middle, and then things behind the scenes kind of work things out to your benefit, and then maybe you don't get to see the results of those until October. They're saying definitely focus on things that are new. Your theme this month is all about new beginnings. You know, when somebody, for example,
this energy is a little bit, it's about newness, but it's also about hearing, like hearing with your ears or clairaudiently about new opportunities for fun. So if somebody invites you out, you shouldn't say, oh, you know, I'm too overextended. I can't really make it. I've got to focus on this thing. Because one thing might lead to another. Things are brewing behind the scenes that you can't see that will work to your benefit. So your key goal to achieve this month, and they're saying this is about communication. The more that you can share in your joy, the more that you can talk about the things that you desire, the easier they're going to flow to you. Is there anything else on how to do that? And they say this might require you to end certain things, to break contracts, maybe cancel a gym membership, maybe you know, if you've been contemplating a divorce, now's the time to do it. So that you can really have a good amount of fun, because the theme in the beginning of the month is like, okay, we're relinquishing ties to things that were holding us back. We're stepping out of old cycles to fully embrace the new. If something isn't working out for my highest good, I gotta let that go. So obstacles that you'll need to overcome. And they're saying this is all about like kind of karma. If you've acquired some good karma, if you've been a really nice, honest, decent person, then good things are just going to work out for you without you having to do much, especially in the end of the month. But if you haven't been, watch out. They're saying, don't let this be something that causes you fear or anxiety. The reason why the month's theme is joy is because the more that we stay in this energy of love and above and having this trust that if we let go of things that no longer serve us, then, you know, things are going to flow to us that are amazing for us. The more that we trust and believe that, the truer it's going to be. Some of you are going to have a little bit of a fear of letting go, but it's important that you release it, because if it's not good for you, what do you want to hold on to it for? I mean, there is comfort in the familiar, but it's not working for you. So just let it go. They're saying that you are very well aware that the past has nothing to do with what is going to occur in the future, right? And so, you know, patterns don't have to repeat themselves. Just because maybe you grew up poor doesn't mean you always have to be poor, for example. It's about changing our mindset, letting go of those belief systems because they're not serving us anymore, okay? So good news for the month of September is that whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right? The little pains that we go through are often growth. That's why they call them growing pains. They teach us something. They put us on a different path. And so we need to be excited about those things. We have to be, you know, maybe a relationship ends and it was a long one and it wasn't a good relationship, but it's comfortable. We know what to expect. And it's like, well, okay, but I'm excited about how things can be new and different. I'm excited to see how I fare on my own. I'm excited for who might come through next. What it is that we want to avoid is slipping into depressive energies. And that's what's going to happen if we focus on the past and we cling too tight to the things we need to release. So your spirituality modality of focus to help you get through all of these energies this month is actually tarot. So if you don't read tarot for yourself, have a friend do it that you trust. You could get a reading from me or somebody else. You could actually try to start learning tarot for yourself. And there are some videos, if you look in the playlist here, on how to read tarot if you're new to it. You could also start with just oracle cards. Because maybe that will, they're more straightforward. They give you more guidance as to like, hey, this is what we need to work on today. You know, this is the current vibe. So for example, they're saying you can be creative with that. Devising new ideas, innovations, and forms of illumination. You know, maybe pulling one card a day for yourself might kind of give you the inner insight that you need to clear away anything that you're holding on to that no longer serves you, could give you fresh new ideas on how to move forward. Maybe, you know, with those beginning cards about new opportunities for you, perhaps they'll inspire you to create your own business or something like that. So that is September. I love you so much, and I'll see you in October. Thanks for getting all the way to the end of this video with me. Click here to sign up to win a free 20-minute video reading. Click here if you want to see the career and money video. And click here to subscribe.